can do COVID right here, right outside. Right outside of the show. Harlem Music Festival presents Uptown Saturday night. That's the night, 6:30. Well, in the old days, the press used to be over here. And we'll have to see whether it's similar. All right. Good show. How you doing?
Good.
You know where the press goes? Like straight in there again? Or was there a door over that way?
Door, yeah.
There was? I missed it. All right, sorry. Oh, yeah, there it is. Press?
That Kwanzaa may be a annual celebration, but its principles of the Inguza Sala are embraced 7 days a week, all year long. So with that in mind, imagine it is Kwanzaa. So Harlem, please show your love for your Harlem-based company that's 100% dedicated to our culture, for our very own Forces of Nature dance company, Dance Theater.
Uptown, Saturday night, if you follow. Harlem Week. Thank you.
nature, forces of nature. I hope y'all come back in December when they're actually here for Kwanzaa.
Kwanzaa, here at the Apollo. I tell you, for those of you who may not, I know they know this voice. But my name is Debbie Jackson, better known as Debbie B from 107.5 WBLS. For 30 years, I did the Sunday classics with my late husband, Hal Jackson. And this man here.
My name is Billy Green from the Quiet Storm for 107.5 WBLS. I thank you so much for listening to the Quiet Storm as often as you do. Really do appreciate it tremendously. And I know some of you will see me for the very, very first time. You probably thought I was the height of our honorable mayor, de Blasio. I'm not that tall, obviously. But I do appreciate you enjoying the Quiet Storm. And fellas, please don't beat me up when I leave the building. But ladies, where the ladies at? Where the ladies at? Ladies, thank you for making the Quiet Storm number one in the tri-state of New York and, of course, across the country. Thank you so much. We got a good evening on tap.
Oh, we sure do. You know, this is the culmination of everything that's going to be happening. You know, we had all kinds of concerts and things that were going on all week, you know, at Harlem Week. But this is the New York City Homecoming Week, and it's the culmination of all of those concerts that went on. And this is going to be something. And we want to say thank you for coming back and being here with us at the Apollo Theater.
You're still too light on the applause. You understand? Do you understand what kind of building we're in? Like, when we walk through this building, you can feel the spirits of so many people that have been in this building.
Yes, you can.
I mean, I'm talking about the Jackson 5. And I remember talking to the Jackson 5, and they said that the scariest thing was being here at the Apollo Theater.
Wow.
Smokey Robinson, yeah. Marvin Gaye.
Bobby Blue Band.
Ah, the list goes on and on and on.
Dionne
so please.
Sarah
Nancy Wilson. We just called out the legends.
Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, please, for this wonderful establishment, for this wonderful landmark that we are standing in right now, let's make a round of applause. This is a rejoiceful night.
Yeah.
Uptown Saturday night. Uptown, we really have uptown. Is Brooklyn here?
Is the Bronx here?
Is Queens here?
Is Harlem here?
Is Harlem here? Anybody came out down from Westchester?
Yeah. What about Long Island? But Harlem is in the house.
Oh, wait, hold on. Did anybody come through the tunnels or the bridges? Anybody from New Jersey? Yeah. What about Connecticut?
Hey!
Did you say Staten Island?
No.
Staten
Island?
See, I know you think that we forget about D.C. Now, if this is your very, very first time in the Apollo Theater, can you applaud if this is your very first time here?
Thank you for coming.
Thank you
for coming home.
On behalf, we love you more. We love you more. On behalf of the Harlem Chamber of Commerce, though, for putting together a spectacular Harlem Week this year.
Oh, it was fantastic.
It's been fantastic.
Did you come out for Harlem Week?
And the nice thing about it, you know, last year I was in this pandemic, so we
couldn't do anything.
So everything was online, but this year, you guys were there. You had a chance to get out the house.
Yes, we did.
And not only that, we did it virtually as well.
Yes, we did. And you can still go to harlemweek.com and see all of the things that went on during Harlem Week.
You know, I hope that folks really get a good opportunity while we're still out to take advantage of this wonderful opportunity of being in Harlem. Harlem, now look, I gotta be honest with you. I was born in Brooklyn. Hold on.
I was born in Harlem Hospital. I'm a Harlem girl.
I got Harlem roots.
Okay.
My mama had my older brother at Harlem Hospital.
Okay, that's good.
My mama went to Canaan Baptist Church.
Okay.
I'm affiliated at Abyssinian Baptist Church. And once
you're a Harlem American.
that's what I mean. Wow.
Are we ready?
Where am I from? I'm from Brooklyn. Yeah, I'm a Brooklyn boy. Brooklyn, born and raised.
Brooklyn!
But Harlem, the culture of Harlem, is astounding. My mom would talk about endless stories back in the day of how Harlem was jumping every single day, every single day.
And it still is.
And still is.
It just took a back seat with the pandemic, but that's okay, we're back.
And we're gonna jump right now. Because, ladies and gentlemen, it is with distinct honor. Debbie, you know, they say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. So this man's daddy really kind of molded him and got him where he is now, but he has taken things to the next level. This amazing, talented man that you see behind this keyboard is a phenomenal arranger, composer, who has worked tremendously along with Luther Vandross and Beyoncé and endless others. So would you please give a thunderous Harlem round of applause for Nat Alley Jr.
Thank you.
of juice on this phone, so this has got a little taste of everybody. Thank you.
Harlem Chamber of Commerce. For years. I mean, we love Grant's Tomb, and that became spectacular. Unfortunately, we got rained out a little bit this year, but, you know, next year.
We usually get rained out. But you know something? We want to make sure that we thank the mayor of the city of New York, de Blasio, because he's the one who made all of this possible.
Mayor, you cannot leave the building. If you're coming to the building, if you're in the building, please do not leave the building without giving me the recipe to what you eat. So I can try to grow just a little bit more, because most people think I'm tall. I don't know why people think I'm tall.
Because you have a voice.
The voice. And dark skin.
Tall, dark, and handsome.
And about 350 pounds.
No.
Okay, so look, we have the distinct honor.
That's right. This fall, Tony Award winner Ruben Santiago Hudson returns to Broadway, and he's bringing his story of why he wanted to be here, and the woman who raised him. She was just a big-hearted woman, and she raised him, and then he took the story, and you know, you've heard of Lackawanna Blues, right?
Yeah.
Well, it's going on Broadway, and it's going to be there on September 14th. Make sure you get your tickets. And here he is, Ruben Santiago Hudson with the Lackawanna Blues Band.
Harlem Chamber of Commerce. Years. I mean, we love Grant's Tomb, and that became spectacular. Unfortunately, we got rained out a little bit this year, but, you know, next year.
We usually get rained out. But you know something, we want to make sure that we thank the mayor of the city of New York, de Blasio, because he's the one who made all of this possible.
Mayor, you cannot leave the building. If you're coming to the building, if you're in the building, please do not leave the building without giving me the recipe to what you eat. So I can try to grow just a little bit more, because most people think I'm tall. I don't know why people think I'm tall.
Because you have a voice.
The voice. And dark skin.
Tall, dark, and handsome.
And about 350 pounds.
No.
Okay, so look, we have the distinct honor.
That's right. This fall, Tony Award winner Ruben Santiago Hudson returns to Broadway, and he's bringing his story of why he wanted to be here, and the woman who raised him. She was just a big-hearted woman, and she raised him, and then he took the story, and you know you've heard of Lackawanna Blues, right? Well, it's going on Broadway, and it's going to be there on September 14th. Make sure you get your tickets. And here he is, Ruben Santiago Hudson with the Lackawanna Blues Band.
Y'all with me.
Apollo Theater, you're going to get a little taste of what Ain't Too Proud to Beg is all about. So please give it up for Al Temptations. Come on, Carl.
I'm here, what's in the number? You might run out of juice, but you get what you get. That's not.